What is going on, ladies and gentlemen? It is February 84 here, and welcome back to another brand new Emergency 4 with mods. Today we're going to be playing the Northview South County mod. And pretty much today's topic is going to be talking about the Deep Silver's announcement that they're going to be announcing something big at E3, this upcoming E3, which is in June, for those who don't know. Deep Silver is a video game publisher who pretty much producing some good games. They produced the Dead Island series, the Sanctuary series, and now the Ultimate series, which Ultimate I think expected release date is 2016, if I'm not mistaken. So hopefully you can see that in 2016. There's also part of like I said, Sanctuary, Dead Island. They produced the War's Mind. Homefront, and I believe that was all the three big ones, really, that people should know about. But like I said, they're talking about their, like I said, E3 is coming up in June, and if you don't know what E3 is, it's the video game expo, well, the biggest video game export in the United States. I don't know about the world, but in the U.S., it's the biggest gaming expo. Not just gaming expo. I know how to say gaming because that's mainly what people... that's mainly what most... what I think about when I hear E3. When
rabies
I heard
alert.
E3,
neutralize the infected animal. Prevent the rabies from spreading. You will need to treat any victims
electronics
and take them away.
And all, but I have a feeling like video gaming is one of their top tiers that most people focused on is the video gaming aspect of E3. I'm gonna remove this. Next time I go in the editor, I'm gonna remove that. I hate that so bad. Because that's the only interest in. Yeah, that's stupid. But, yeah, they say they had a huge announcement. And, of course, you know, as gamers, we're already speculating on what this what this announcement is. And, pretty much, I have a theory. And I'm gonna tell you my theory.
Yes.
So, like I said, Deep Silver, they produced the Saints Row series and the War's Mind, the Homefront series, the Dead Island series. They produce some good games, some good B, in my, some of them are B-list games. Shoot a dog, should have shot the dog.
Copy.
There we go.
Roger.
But, like I said, everybody's speculating. So, in my opinion,
fire caused by negligent handling of flammable materials. Extinguish all fires.
The next Saints Row. Is it a small fire? Can I put it out with police officers or do I need an engine? Looks like I need an engine. Looks like it's inside this building. All right, let's get engine 82 there. Where was it? Here? No, here.
Roger.
Excuse me, I apologize. But I can hopefully see them doing E3. Of course they're doing E3. I can hopefully see them doing a new Saints Row, and that's what I believe is going to be the big announcement for E3 that they're talking about. Besides the, you know, their normal, well, the ones that already people already know about is Homefront 2: The Revolution and Dead Island 2. Both of those are already in the works. And they are expected to come out this year. I don't know when the exact dates. I think Dead Island 2, it just says 2016, I believe. What's the other name of it? Homefront. Homefront, I think their expected release date is probably going to be fall. Fall of 2016, most likely, if I'm just, you know, guessing here. But I can see them doing another Homefront. Jesus, I'm just all over the place. I can see them doing another Saints Row. I don't think we gotta chop down the door. We probably gotta chop down the door. That's what I'm saying. Some of these doors are weird. Like in the LA Mall, you don't gotta chop down this door. Perfect. Okay.
It's done.
And you guys can't use extinguishers inside?
Attention. Rioting civilian. Arrest and remove. If necessary, treat any casualties and take them away.
I'm gonna set them up so we can just go in here and extinguish. Okay, you can't walk in here. I don't know why you can't walk in. I was just gonna leave it alone. Looks like the person running amok is right next to the fire. But the Homefront Revolution, they're expecting release date is 2016. It doesn't have fall or October. Fall or winter. But if I had to guess, I'd say fall. I have a feeling it's gonna be released in the fall time. If I had to make a good assumption. Is this over? I think it's over. It is over, okay. Yeah, if I had to make a quick assumption, I think it's going to be released in the fall. But, back to that Nature Hand, like I said, I have a feeling it's going to be the next Saints Row. So it's probably going to be like Saints Row the... I don't think it's going to be Saints Row the 5th. Saints Row. We're talking about Saints Row here. We're talking about Saints Row. Okay. The first one, Saints Row, Saints Row 2, Saints Row the 3rd, and then... What was this called? I think it was called Saints Row. I think Saints Row 4 was called Initiation. Oh no, it was called Saints Row 4. So yeah, okay, called Saints Row 5. So I have a feeling they're gonna take it back old school, and well, I don't have a feeling. I think they should take it back old school and do games versus games and stop all this high-powered BS, this extraterrestrial and. You got, you kind of say Saints Row the 3rd was gangs versus gangs, but then again, you was like a corporation. It was a corporate gang versus a corporate gang. It was a corporate gang versus a bigger gang, pretty much. It was all one gang, especially the other one, it was ran by that one dude, Waffle, the French Waffle? Oh, hell, the Belgian Waffle. As Johnny Gat called him, the Belgian Waffle. It was pretty much just one. He was pretty much in control of three smaller games. The Morningstar. Actually, I think that was his name, Morningstar. Okay, I know one gang was called Morningstar. The other ones was the Luchadors, and I think that's I don't remember the Techno one. The Techno gang. But it was just they were all controlled pretty much by the same guy, the Belgian Waffle guy, and it really wasn't a gang versus gang. I mean, you was in penthouses and had all types of weapons and had this fancy clothing and pretty much you was able to fancy yourself. Well, you actually, I'm not gonna say the fancy clothing because you was able to do that in Saints Row 2 and 1, but penthouses and you got your own casino and stuff like that. I mean, I'd like to take it to the old school, you know, streets versus street drive-bys and, you know, rolling up on a drug dealer and beating the hell out of him with a pink dildo. I mean, that's just, ooh, that's so classic, Saints Row. But I just want to see it go all the way back to the old school. You know, not all the way back.
We have a report of pickpocketing. The thief is escaping. Arrest him and take him away.
Can you go? I just heard like a huge crash. I don't know what that was. I have a feeling she's finished. Yeah, let's go. But yeah, I'm not saying get rid of everything. I mean, keep like the graphics and the skill tree that that they introduced in Saints Row 3. Keep the, you know, the and they always had contacts. It's okay. What else did I like about Saints Row 3? Well, Saints Row, like I said, Saints Row 1 and 2, in my opinion, were good. I mean, I don't think they should have changed anything from Saints Row 1 to Saints Row 2. I like how they... What was it? I think they both was in the same area. Yeah, they both was in the same territory. I mean, they both was the same map, but the map had aged, to put it that way. So, like, I love it when they do that with maps. Like, in Grand Theft Auto Vice City, there was one in one part of the city, there was a Ferris wheel that wasn't even constructed yet.
Almost there.
And the good thing about it is that when Saints Row, when Grand Theft Auto Vice City stories came out, I cannot talk today. In Vice City, it was a Ferris wheel was being built. In Vice City Stories, the Ferris wheel was finished. So there, it wasn't still being built. It was finished because it's pretty much, I think the time lapse between both was maybe not four years. I want to say a year and a half between Vice City and Vice City Stories. So in a year and a half, you expect something to be built. So
attention,
in a year and a half,
there is a person running amok in the operational area.
You don't expect
arrest
to see the
or
same
neutralize
thing
this
over
person
and, over.
And take him away. And don't forget to treat those victims.
Is he in the wall? Man, what car is he here? Oh man, the pedophile man. Come on, hurry, get it, get it, get it. We got there just in time. Is that the one I think this is the one I modified. If I'm not mistaken, yes, I modified this one. All I did was change the front red and blue. I mean, the front reds to blue, and then change the backs, whatnot. Actually, no, that's not the one I modified. I don't think it is. Because I think I removed the radiation.
Central, I'll be 1019, 1051.
But, yeah, hopefully they take it. Oh, ooh, holy crap, I forgot all about them. Okay, everybody else in the safe? Okay, everything looks like everybody
Attention,
else is...
rioting civilian. Arrest and remove. Safe. If necessary, treat any casualties and take them away.
Ooh, how the hell you can get back to him? Have to pull in the parking lot? Most likely, pull in the... You guys go in the front, or you're just going to glitch through the wall and do it there. I don't know. But Saints Row the Fifth is pretty much the main game I'm really looking forward to, and what I think is going to be an announcement. But there also could be smaller announcements. Like they're going to most likely release the probably give us a not a, a estimation, an estimation of when Red Dead Redemption, estimation on when. Homefront Revelation, I mean Revolution is coming out. They might announce the same thing. They might do the same thing with Dead Island 2. Might give us an estimated date. Speaking of Red Dead Redemption, I heard they was making another one. So that's gonna be fun. I never played number one, but actually I played like maybe an hour to number one. And that was it. That's just stupid. The longest he could have got up and ran. He didn't. Excuse me. So tired. I don't know why I'm tired.
It's okay.
But yeah. There's a lot of things. Well, that's just Deep Silver. I mean, so far, Deep Silver is the only one I really heard about making a huge... I mean, you know, letting people know there's going to be something huge at E3 that they're going to be bringing out or showcasing. That's the only one I heard so far. I don't know if anybody else is doing a huge showcase. I'm trying to think. Who could do a huge showcase? E3. Jesus. This is, my brain is just, no. EA, they could do a huge announcement by finally letting us know what the hell the next Battlefield will be. People have been speculating right. Battlefield 5 is going to be World War 2, and others are saying, nope, it's not, because most people want to take it back to 19, I think it was Battlefield 1942, 1945, something like that. And people want to redo that, but with I mean, they want to pretty much do the same thing.
Roger.
Well, not the same thing, but they want to bring back the World War II feel of it, but just with the Frostbite 3 engine. So, EA could possibly finally give us a hint on what the hell is going to be about, because Battlefield 4 is done. They're not making any more DLCs for that. So I think right now they're pretty much focusing all their work on Battlefield 5.
It's done.
So that's why I have a feeling like, and E3 comes out, they might have a trailer. Yeah, they might have a trailer. And if they don't have, yeah, they definitely going to have a trailer by E3. Yeah, I'm just going to go ahead and say it now. At E3, we're going to see Battlefield 5 trailer. I'm saying that now. Hell, we might see a Call of Duty one, but in my opinion, I'm not a Call of Duty fan. I think Call of Duty's dead. It's just the same stuff, repetitive. It's the same stuff over and over and over. They just copy, paste, and add textures, and that's it. But, Battlefield 5, what I would like to see from Battlefield 5, actually, Battlefield 5. I could see another Bad Company 3. That would be awesome. Well, actually, yeah, they could make a... They should make a Bad Company 3. They definitely should, because I just remember Bad Company... Nope. Wait, I think I am wrong. Bad Company 1 and 2 were both in Desert Storm, if I'm not mistaken.
Attention,
yes,
we have
a
report of pickpocketing. The thief is escaping. Arrest him and take him away.
Let's see, Battlefield 5. What would be best for me from Battlefield 5? Is this her crossing? Yeah, that's her crossing the street. Nope, that's him. Ooh, that's a good one. I don't know what I would expect from Battlefield 5. I mean, I really haven't played any World War II Battlefields. like I said, only ones I really played were Bad Company, Bad Company 2. Actually, I didn't play Bad Company 2. I just played like the demo version. So I just played Bad Company, Battlefield 3, Battlefield 2, because Project Reality was Battlefield 2, and Battlefield something, the story mode of Battlefield 4. Excuse me. And he's dead. Alright, let's get an ambo, which is conveniently right next door.
It's okay.
Copy. 10-4.
So, I don't know. I don't know what I can think about Battlefield 5. I don't know. All I know is I will be... I do know this. They should definitely not do Cops and Robbers. They should definitely leave that alone. Like, Battlefield Home Hardline, it was a good game, but it wasn't. It's not Battlefield. It's not Battlefield. When I hear Battlefield, I don't think of Cops and Robbers. I don't think of Hardline. I think of something totally different. When I think of Cops and Robbers, when I think of Battlefield Hardline, I probably think of... Actually, no, I do think of Battlefield. I don't know. I just think Battlefield and Hard... I mean, I just think Battlefield and Cops and Robbers don't go together. So, that's just... Yeah. But, yeah, like I said, I don't know about Battlefield 5. I don't know. But other games I wish, I hope that they make an introduction. Or at least not an introduction, but give us some type of hint. I really want to see a new Midnight Club. I really do. I mean, LA, I think LA was made about, I want to say 2008. So that's almost about 5+ years ago. Since the last Midnight Club, and we've just been sitting here without one.
Roger.
And I really think it's time for them to start getting back into some of these old games. Midnight Club, I would really love to see a newer one of that. LA Noir 2 would definitely love to see that. That's one of my favorite games. I love LA Noir. It's just one of them games where you can play over and over, even though it's kind of, well, no, it's not. I mean, depending on how you play, you can just play it over and over. I play with like a true detective. I don't use none of the hints. And I mean, the first time I played, I used hints. The second time, I actually walked around and took a lot of call-outs, some of the ones that came over, like, the radio scanner, and pretty much I was very active after. Like, after you finished the story, and everything, I still played it just to answer the calls and stuff and drive around and collect the cards and suits and stuff. I just still did that. But LA Noir 2, I really would love to see that. What else? Let's see. We talked about Midnight Club. It was another one too. Midnight Club. Oh, what? I forgot the name of it. Oh wow, I really forgot the name, and it's sad because I haven't played it in a long time. We're just waiting for another call out. Oh, we've got the Order Squad.
Central, be advised, I'm 1097 in the area.
Yeah, I don't know. Hopefully E3. Hopefully this E3 is going to be very, very good.
Central, I'll be 1019,
1051. Oh, yes. I saw this as a blog. I don't know if it was a blog or... excuse me, or somebody was actually suggesting this as a game, but someone said a Halo Division, a Halo version of Division would be awesome. And it kind of got me, when I saw it and read it, I read the whole thing, and the entire thing, and...
Attention, arson in the operational area.
The way that
arrest
they had
the arsonist and
talked
take him
about
away.
It,
extinguish
it
all fire.
Sounds fucking awesome, to be honest. It sounds fucking awesome to... there he is. There he is, right there. I'm just going to cheat. I don't feel like... I don't think we're going to be able to get back there. Yeah, we're not getting back there on the trucks. So we're just going to... Let's hope police can get there and get him before the fire plane does. Because I have a feeling when the fire plane comes, he's going to die. And you guys are just going to... Thanks, guys. You know what? We should just wait until the fire is out.
Roger.
Looks like I'm gonna have to control these guys myself.
It's okay. Copy.
Go arrest. Alright. Oh, good. He's running away. Come over here. Come on. Oh, don't set the house on fire. Don't set the house on fire, you piece of shit. You set the house on fire. I'm going to wait. Because I have a feeling, even though he's still close enough, that plane's going to get that shit, the water on him, the contaminated water. Oh, it didn't put the, it put the, oh, okay, good. It put the, that out. So, hey, can you grab an extinguisher?
Yes.
I don't know if you want to be able to take this by yourself, so I might have to just call in another engine. I think engine 23 or 80. Oh, I think it's 23, 81. Oh, good. He's running to her. Get him. Good. Before he starts another fire. Oh, okay, good. So that water, the water did injure him. Okay, well, at least we can get... Right there we go.
It's okay.
Yeah, let's go ahead and get the engine over here too.
It's okay.
Yes.
Yep, because there's a tree. Okay, well, looks like this is going to be the last one we do, but E3 is going to be, in my, E3 is always epic, but I have a feeling this E3 is going to be even more epicer, which is, I don't even know if that's a word or not. This E3 should be the best one in history. I can't wait to it. Comes out. I also think... Whatever the next Battlefield is, by E3, Jesus, DICE, or I think it was either DICE or EA, I think it was DICE who mass produced, who pretty much took blame, not blame, but took the reins of Battlefield 3, Battlefield 4. When Battlefield 4 first came out, they had the US versus American tournament, or like the battle, the US versus Europe, it took 50 players. Was it 50? Yeah, I think they took 25. It's 64 man slots. 64 man servers. 632. I think they took about 32 Europeans and 32 Americans and put them inside the... Actually, no, Cap, come back. You can get in. I need you to drive up this driveway and extinguish this house. Yeah, because this is getting out of hand. Alright, well, it looks like we're going to need the other... No, that's the tanker. Oh, looks like it's going to be only person one in there. Alright, we're going to dispatch this entire station. Unfortunately, I'm gonna need you guys to come back because now you guys. I'm gonna wrap it before you guys. All right, let's go ahead and get the firefighter out of there.
Roger.
He's in the home way. Let's pull the cops out too. Because they're really not going to do much.
10-4.
Roger.
Oh. Okay, that blew up. Looks like squad 283? Yeah, squad 83 is arriving. I sent you guys on the opposite side of the cul-de-sac.
It's okay.
10-4.
Oh, no. Not yet. Just go straight. Okay. Sit you right behind him. Cops are gonna have to get out. Are they in? It looks like one more left. And he's waiting for him to get in. Is he in? Oh my god, why is he not in? There we go. Alright, Rocket deploy.
Yes.
Alright, need you guys with your chainsaws.
Yes.
Roger. Roger.
Come on, cop, move! Police! This fire is getting out of hand. Is it spreading over to the bushes? Actually, I can't cut those trees, so most likely that fire will just burn out. Alright, let's keep grabbing some... Yeah, grab some hoses.
Roger.